your sketch looks something like this. So the first graph is this x plus 1 for x less than or equal to 1. So the idea is that you are looking at the graph from all x values less than or equal to 1. The equal to made your closed circle, and the plus 1 told you your y-intercept. The second graph is 1 over x. So 1 over x from 1 to 3 does not have a domain issue as if it would if it was from 0 to 1 or something else. So that's my orange graph. And then my green graph is this graph here of the square root from 3 up to infinity. So is this graph continuous? No. Where do we have issues? So 1 and 3 are going to be my points of concern. So we would say that at x equals 1 and x equals 3, we have discontinuities. It says find the numbers at which f is discontinuous. At which of these numbers is f continuous from the right, the left, or neither? So at x equals 1 and 3, we have jump discontinuities. However, at 1, is my graph continuous from the left or from the right?
Left.
Because the closed circle is consistent to the left. So this is a left continuous. At x equals 3, am I continuous from the left or from the right? So it's right-hand continuous. And like we said, both of these have jump discontinuity. So they're discontinuous at those points, but they are right-hand or left-hand continuous, x equals 1 and x equals 3, respectively. Does that make sense? So what left-hand and right-hand continuity tells you is that the limit is equal to that value at that point. So what this left-hand continuous tells me is that the limit as x approaches 1 from the left of f of x equals f of 1. Thank you. Or the limit as x approaches 3 from the right of f of x equals f of 3. What's up, Kat?
I heard you found a stats book.
No, I found Alma's stats book. Her name was in it and everything. I called her down to get it.
Right. Not good,
it.
Hannah.
I don't know. I had
You're starting to sound like Josh.
And somebody borrowed it, and I haven't seen it since. And they couldn't give it back to me. Yes.
Okay.
Which means it's somewhere.
Be on the lookout.
All right, thank you. It's somewhere.
I lost a $180 book over the summer, and I was supposed to pay for it. I never did, and then someone ended up turning it in, so I looked for it.
Yeah, did you check the office?
Yeah.
Go check the office.
Alright, I haven't told Miss Lacey yet though, so like, don't tell Miss Lacey.
Guys, we need to take them out of our lockers.
I never made it to my locker.
Secret's safe, Hannah.
Okay.
You literally don't
It's recorded.
Oh,
I said, your secret saves Hannah, and I said, although it's being recorded.
Oh.
Hi, Dustin.
You need to erase the tapes.
Hi,
Dustin.
Hi,
Peter.
Feel better.
Yeah, feel
better, dude.
Wait, so is that where we end for that one? Yes, that's it. That's all it
asked.
Alright, example 5. Does the function have removable discontinuity at x equals 2? If the discontinuity is removable, find a function that would make it true. In ours, a slight typo, because it should be x equals negative 2. Yeah. Slight typo. I missed my negative sign.
On both of them?
Yeah, like this should be an x equals negative 2. Or I just had to change my denominator to x minus 2. I don't know, but that factor cancels. So we're going to fix the one. So that literally hinted at where we're going next. when you see a function and it's asking about discontinuity or an asymptote or a limit, functions get factored. How does the numerator factor? So what does that simplify to? So, this is what removable discontinuity has a value for. And this was kind of on our quiz the other day where it talked about, is there a vertical asymptote? And if you didn't factor it, you're like, yeah, there's a vertical asymptote at x equals negative 2, and you tried to move on. But there isn't a vertical asymptote at x equals negative 2. Because at x equals negative 2, the function isn't going to an infinity. The function is approaching a point. It's just there's an open circle. So what's happening is on your graph at x equals negative 2, we're going to have a hole. And what the limit does is it tells me where that hole is. So the limit as x approaches negative 2 for my original f of x is equal to negative 2 minus 4. Or negative 6. So what that means is in terms of this graph, is if I put this original f of x function in to my calculator, see Josh doesn't believe me. If I put this original f of x function into my calculator, you're going to see a line. You're not going to see this hole because our graphing calculators aren't that sweet and they don't put those holes there. You need to know that hole is there because you need to look at the original f of x and do Casey's favorite thing in the entire world, which is say, what's the domain of my original f of x? So the domain would be negative infinity to infinity, except, oh, if I could spell, x does not equal negative 2. You could have also said, if you like to do it like this, you could do that as well. Does this graph have left or right hand continuity? No. Good, so it's not left or right hand continuous. Yes?
If you're right in the domain correct, you just write all real numbers and then x cannot be negative 2.
Yep. Yep.
So, like, this is like confusing me. Was there a problem with just like this on the test?
Where one factored and it canceled out? Yes.
Where, like, it wasn't going towards infinity, it was just like line, but because.
You had to factor it.
It was a trick.
Yeah. It's trick.
It's true. I think I actually found it. I think I remember plugging them all into my crafting calculator.
So the next one is, can you find a function g that agrees with f and makes it continuous? How could I make that red graph over there continuous? What do I need?
Negative 2.
I need a point, right? I just need negative 2 to equal negative 6. I need this to exist. So, precisely. So when x equals negative 2, I need this graph to equal negative 6. And then around it, it could be my other graph. So it can be x minus 4 for x values less than negative 2, and x minus 4 for x values greater than negative 2. But at negative 2, I need it to be negative 6. You can. Anything? Yeah. You could also have written the f of x function, the original one. So, like, you can even, because f of x is defined, you could do this and write in here where your piece was. You can write f of x. I don't need you to write the x squared minus 2x minus 8 all over x plus 2. Yes.
So, even though it's undefined at that point,
We redefined it. We created, we're doing a new part. That's why I went to purple. So the second part was find a function g that agrees with f for x equals negative 2 and makes it continuous. So we created some function g that makes this original f of x continuous.
Instead of saying the x is less than negative 2 or x greater than negative 2, could you do the not equal to?
I've never seen a piecewise defined that way. I know. I've hesitated with that before. I've just never seen it mathematically. I know. I've never seen it. So I would hate to tell you yes and then like it not give you credit. What I've done, I don't know if you have this. This is just kind of me. I don't think you do. This was me summarizing today. Basically, we have three big points. If f and g are continuous at a and c is a constant, then the following are also continuous at a. All polynomial functions are continuous everywhere because their domain is all real. All polynomials are continuous everywhere because their domain is all reals. A rational function is continuous wherever it is defined, i.e. continuous on its domain. So rationals would be like 1 over x. That's a rational function. It's continuous on its domain. What's its domain not include? 0. That's its infinite discontinuity. Think about 0 on a rational. It's going whoop. So infinite. The following are always continuous on their domain. So things that are continuous on their domain would be like square roots, cubics, etc. Yes.
So, like, asymptotes are not continuous on their domain. Well, no, sorry, they are, but, like...
Asymptotes aren't a type of graph.
So, like, how do those?
A graph can have an asymptote, and it would be considered continuous on its domain with that asymptote. However, it contains a point of infinite discontinuity.
Okay.
Homework is in the book. You have, again, like 25 minutes to get started on this.
I don't write down my